Hey guys, and I'm back with another ATC video. In case you missed the last video, I ended up signing up for a huge card trade in which people create a deck of cards and affix what I guess you'd call inspirational quotes to it. Of course, when I do this project, I tend to lean toward interesting rather than inspirational. I don't feel like I'm much of a source of inspiration, but I do like interesting things, so that's what I do. And to complete a set of 52 cards, I decided to break it up into smaller batches. When you create a large number of cards at the same time, it's really good to just start with one sheet of paper, apply some kind of decoration to it, and then cut it out and individualize each card. This has a bit more of a production line kind of feel to it. And the theme for this trade is favorite books, authors, and films. And I've broken down my giant batch of cards into groups of 9, and each group is going to be dedicated to one book or film. And like I said in the last video, I tend to just have a standby answer to the what is your favorite blank question. Even if it's kind of outdated and old, I will still kind of turn to it in case someone suddenly asks me. And this is no exception. So one standby answer to the what is your favorite movie question, I actually usually say Vanilla Sky. It's kind of a guilty pleasure kind of answer. I feel kind of embarrassed by it. I guess because a lot of people don't like that movie. A lot of people think it's kind of weird. I remember the first time I saw it, this was in high school, and I had gone to the movie with my friend, and it was kind of an awkward movie to watch with a friend. And I do remember we spent a lot of time afterwards talking about how confusing and strange it was, and we couldn't decide if we'd liked it or not. But it was definitely one of those films that appealed to me more the more that I watched it. Like, every time I saw it, I would see more and more clues as to, you know, what the answer was. There's a ridiculous amount of foreshadowing in that movie, so every time I watched it, I would just see a new clue. And then I guess it would just feel satisfying to pick up something new each time I watched it. So for these cards, I decided to paint them as what people usually consider a vanilla sky. It's like a very lightly clouded blue sky, and it was a bit more challenging than I expected. I don't know why I struggled a little bit with making it look like an actual sky, but I still like it. I also wanted to fit sparkly gold paint in all of my cards to unify them, even though each grouping is going to look pretty different. So these cards are slightly less interesting or labor intensive because I didn't draw anything specific on it. Unfortunately, with this movie, Vanilla Sky, I was unable to find 9 good quotes from it. I was mostly just drawing like BuzzFeed lists and things like what's your favorite quote from this movie, blah blah blah. And there wasn't really that many that I really liked, so I had to repeat them. I kind of wish that I had searched out a script for it, which I did in a different group that's coming up. For that one, I did find a copy of like the written script online, so I was able to kind of flip through it, through all the dialogue and narration and stuff, to find sentences that I thought were really interesting. But I didn't find any for this movie, so I just picked some that I liked, and yeah, so there's some repeats. Anyway, thank you for watching this video, and I'll see you next time.